I guess it all started quite a few years ago at the movies. I used to go to a lot of those kiddie matinees. It was a nice, pleasant way to spend Saturday afternoons.
Because you're going to a Malibu beach party right at your movie theater.
Of course, a lot of my school friends didn't take the movies as seriously as I did in those days. In fact, some of them did some pretty weird things there. Yeah, some very weird things. But I was different. I went to the movies to see the movies, especially the movies they were showing that day. Oh, there I am now, waiting for the main show to start. No, no, you're passing me. Wait, you passed me. Go back. Oh, thanks. See, that's me, with the curly hair and the glasses. Now I want you to meet some of my favorite people. I guess they were my best friends, but they became my biggest problem. That's Mo. He's like the boss, the leader. Yeah. And then there's Larry. He acts sort of, you know, stupid. Oh, and there's Shem. He's funny. Oh, there's Curly, too. You'll meet him later.
Listen to this letter. Gentlemen.
That ain't for us. We're not gentlemen. Speak for yourself.
Oh!
Now, you've got to agree, these guys are funny. But for some reason, not everyone seemed to care about them as much as me.
That put us out of business. What'll we do?
You guys worry about that. I'm too young to worry and get wrinkles on my pretty little face.
Oh, a funny man.
That's the matter with you.
What we need is a little music to cheer us up.
See, this is a story about a guy who just wanted to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. What's wrong with that? But people wouldn't let him. Sometimes he even had to fight back.
We test your heart and then collect the reward, then we can pay our bills.
My name's Howard. Howard F. Howard. Now, I'm a Stooge maniac.
You bet. This is the store where your dollars have more sense.
Say, we've got the very sport coat you're looking for.
I don't want a coat.
But listen, mister, we're going to give you a bottle. Where did you ever get this mess?
I bought it here.
Oh, what a beautiful masterpiece.
Here. Isn't it a beauty?
Genuine import. Smell the ocean.
And it's 200% wool.
200%?
Yeah, these sheep led a double life.
Yes, sir.
And I'll get it on right in there.
I don't want it.
Right.
Will you?
I don't want a coat.
I don't want a coat.
I don't want a coat.
Oh, he don't want a coat.
What he wants is a pair of our slick slacks.
Don't you tell me the man wants slacks. Get him slacks. Go ahead. Oh, yes. Try him right on.
Gee, officer, we...
Yes. Quiet! You birds realize you just let Terry Hargan, the bank robber, slip right through my hands? I ought to run you in.
Please, officer. I got six wives and two kids.
Honest, officer. There was nobody came in here.
Well, he's in the neighborhood. Keep a sharp lookout. I'll be back.
Right.
Right.
Oh.
Take off your hat. Take off your hat.
No.
Now raise your right hand.
Raise your right hand.
Take off your hat. Off your hat. Now place your left hand here. Left hand here.
Oh, yes, man. We can do the boys.
Now place your left hand here. Left hand here. Take off your hat. Raise your right hand. Now put your left hand here. Please take off your hat. Raise your right hand. Now put your left hand here. Will you please take off your hat? Raise your right hand. Now put your left hand here. Take off your hat. Raise your right hand. Will you get rid of that hat?
Raise your right hand.
Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth?
Huh?
Do you solemnly swear to tell us who's told you that nothing's the truth?
Are you trying to give me the double talk?
Do you solemnly swear to tell us who's told truth and nothing but the truth?
Why don't you answer him?
He's talking pig Latin. I don't know what he's saying.
He's asking you if you'll swear to tell the truth.
Truth is stranger than fiction, Judgy Wudgy.
Take the stand.
Where did I put it?
No, no. Take the stand.
I got it. Now what'll I do with it?
Sit down.
You're in the court, not in Clancy's pool. Clancy's pool.
Time to get back to your favorite comedy team, the Three Stooges.
Stand still, will you? We gotta get going. It's 3 o'clock now.
Yes? And if you don't marry that girl by 6 o'clock, we're out of the money.
I said stand still.
Sales. We got Dell, we're going to buy sports and salad dressing, soup, suspenders, Molly. Super savings on screws, searchlights, seals, stationery, staplers.
Sexy specials on steel, dim shift, shutters, skirts, sheets, and cherries.
If it starts with an S, it's on Sure, solder, solvent, spice, firm bank, speedometers.
Swimming lessons, singing telegrams?
Certainly. Say, but Sal's, you'll be fine, Sal. Put up on 6 and Sullivan off the 605 in your terminal.
And now, let's get back to the Three Stooges.
Oh, my head is off! My head is off! Oh, there I am, and as pretty as a picture.
Yeah, the name.
Oh, get gone.
No woman's interested in me. Maybe not, pal. But if you look real hard, you might find one that sits in the head of a buck.
Yeah, John, right, he has.
Now, hello?
Married to a dame like that.
Howard residence, Howard F. Howard speaking.
Hi.
Hi. Are you cutie?
Howard, not on the phone, God.
Oh, I mean, good morning, Beverly.
I love it when you say good morning, Howard.
You do?
I just called to make sure you didn't forget our little lunch date.
That was to eat lunch, right?
Yeah. So the Casa Sahara at 1 o'clock, right?
Perfect. Perfect.
You're not going to act that way with my parents, are you?
Act what way?
Oh,
here you are.
That way you act when you act that way?
Boy, am I tired. Where do I throw this water?
Oh, that way. Today you're going to see the new Howard F. Howard.
Just as long as you save the good parts from the old Howard, you adorable thing, you.
So come on down. Take a bath. We got a special home in honor of the Three Stooges. I call it Three in a Tub. Three in a Tub for the price of 2 in a Tub. Hollywood Hot Tub. Take a bath. Sorry, no dogs.
It could happen to anyone, even you. That's right, you. Do you talk kind of funny? Do you walk kind of funny? Do you act funny? Like a stooge? Isn't it enough to make you sick? Well, it could happen to you. Maybe you're already acting like this. Before it's too late. Before you start acting like this. Call Stooge Hills, the Stoogetarium that cares. Call Stooge Hills now. Remember, today you may see one, but tomorrow you may be one.
No, Ann, could you, hurry, please?
And here comes the big guy!
And now, let's get back to the Three Stooges.
I wasn't worried. Maybe I should have been. I went to work. It was a bright new morning, and I was ready to take on the world.
Use the crop water, Ring!
Hey, watch it!
Hey, look at those!
Again!
sorry, Mr. Krull. That's Krull. Krull! Krull!
Sorry, Mr. Krull.
Stupid day again, right?
Well,
I don't want to hear it. Look, Howard. Howard, you're a nice boy and everything. But you're an idiot! Now get to work! And this, fixation of yours, it's making you act a little, you know? And it's getting in the way of your work. Now you mess up one more time. One more time, and you're fired. Hey, wait! Stop!
Yes, it seemed like an ordinary day, but when I finally started work, I noticed a change coming over me. Was it the cleaning fluid? Or was it something else?
Well, anyway, I got the spot out.
Who wants lunch?
I do. Steak me some too, will you?
Okay, coming up.
Another movie started in my head. Or was it a movie? I don't know. But anyway, I must have been leaning on the steam button while I watched it, because... Well, it wasn't my fault. I mean, the place wasn't really on fire, was it?
Wacko! Yo, Wacko! Sorry, Mr. Krull! Got a problem.
I was out of a job. I figured I'd better get some help. I hoped I could find it here, at the Wacko building.
Singing about the voices of spring, not the eruption of a volcano. Give with the throat, not with the bellows.
Oh, Professor, you want it more like a bird.
That's it. That's it. Give me the bird.
Doctor?
One, two, three, and one, two, three, and there we are. Feel a little better? That's it. Don't go away. Yeah, I had to give my nurse a Heimlich maneuver. In reverse, she had something stuck in her back. Feel better now? Now, what can I do for you?
Well, I've got this problem.
Right, naturally, you got a problem. That's why you came here, right? Well, what seems to be your problem? Yeah. Huh?
Well, it's kind of hard to say.
Don't be shy. Come on. I've heard many, many things. I've heard many, many things. Don't worry, you're not going to shock me.
Okay. I'm hearing things.
Yeah.
And I'm seeing things, too. Like I'm standing there, and all of a sudden, the boom.
Yeah.
There's Mo, or there's Larry, or there's Curly, or shit. I mean, everywhere I go, there's something happening, and I don't know what to do.
All right. There we are. Now, we're going to calm you down. We go over to the couch. That's the workbench, all right?
Couch?
The couch. Go over to the couch. Come on.
Okay.
All right. Have me sterilized all over here where he touched me. All right. Now, just lie down. Get nice and comfortable. Don't get too comfortable. Oh, you're right. Get comfortable.
Yeah.
Comfortable?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Now, tell me about your earliest memories.
Oh, I guess my earliest memory was, at the movies. My parents would leave me at the movies.
Why would they leave you at the movies?
Well, I guess it was cheaper than having a babysitter.
We were making progress, but I got so involved with my treatment that I forgot the lunch at the Moroccan restaurant with Beverly's parents. And Beverly never liked it when I was late. It made her nervous. And when she gets nervous, sometimes she throws up.
You'll just love Howard. He's so different. Why, just the other day I said to him, Howard, you're so different. Come here.
He's not one of those puckers, is he?
Sorry, Daddy. Pucker?
Punkers, I think they call them, dear.
Those fellas with earrings.
Rye hands.
Your father gets nervous every time he sees a boy wearing earrings, dear.
Some of them wear one earring.
Well, actually, no, Howard kind of likes old-fashioned things. See, he's different. No, weird.
Okay, I was late, but this was important. I was on my way to being cured. The doctor seemed to get right to the source of my problem.
Ball and Larry and Curly.
They're funny. How do you like them?
Well, they're funny.
Why are they funny? What
do you
mean?
You know, the stuff they do.
When they hit each other?
Yeah, that's funny.
You like when they hit
each other? Oh, yeah,
I like when they smack them in the face, right?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Punch them in the stomach.
Yeah, I like that, too.
And poke them in the eyes.
Oh, you poke
them
in the eyes.
And they hit them all
right
in the
face.
You like all that,
oh, yeah.
You like the smacking and the punching and the smacking and the crunching around and the smacking and the bumping. You are in love with pain.
What? Yes, sir.
You are in love with pain. You are enchanted with pain. Yes.
I don't think
yes,
so.
Yes, you are a voyeur of pain. You like to watch it, but you don't like to feel it, because you don't know what pain is. You have to feel pain to know what pain is. Come. I want you to feel what pain is. Come over here, please. Come. By the way, knife, get ready. This is a very radical procedure, but it's for your own good. You will love me afterwards. You'll beg. I'm telling you. All right. Knife, smack him in the face.
No.
That's it. Now, punch him in the stomach.
No.
Give me those glasses. Poke him in the eyes. That's it. Now smudge him in the stomach. Now smack him in the face. That's it. Now punch him in the stomach. All right, put that. Now punch him in the eye. One more poke in the eye. That's it. Activate. Now put him on there. That's it. See that? Doesn't that feel better now? Now you know what the pain is. You feel the pain. You know what the pain is. But you see, I can't let you have her. She's mine. You
okay.
Can't have her all the time. You understand?
Yeah.
So you're going to have to do this by yourself. That's what psychiatry is. I can make suggestions to you, but you have to do it by yourself. You're going to have to beat yourself up. You understand? Now watch yourself. Give yourself a smack. Come on, watch out. Give him a smack. Go ahead. Smack yourself again. No, come on. Get mad at yourself. Give yourself a little pain.
He's dead. That's the way.
Ah, and put on the guns again. And
land down. No, I'm shot.
Oh, my God. That's it.
Wait.
Yeah. What is it? You hear that?
The movie.
You see it?
You see that movie?
Oh,
yeah, the movie.
And there they were again, on the doctor's wall. This was turning out to be a very unusual day.
That's it. He's interested in the movie. All right, we got a couple of minutes to kill here, so while he's watching the movie, you and I will make some moves.
I order.
You order what?
I ought to be a little more careful.
Well,
shut up and listen. Do you remember your Uncle Caleb?
Do I? Why, that old tightwad heat steel flies from a blind spider.
But, Champ, he's...
He's a louse and a weasel.
Yeah, well, he just died and left you $500,000.
Just like that old skinflint. $500,000!
Poor old Uncle Caleb. Like I was saying, he was a swell guy. Give me the shirt off his back, yeah, and throw in the buttons, too.
But there's one little catch. You get the dough provided you're married.
So
married? No. No, fellas. I'm gonna faint. I'm gonna faint.
Doctor?
Yes, sir. Oh, you finished with the movie?
Oh, yes.
Oh, was it a good movie?
Oh, yeah, it was funny.
Good. Was there a Looney Tune?
No.
But they're Bugs Bunny?
No, Doctor, that's what I want to talk to you about. I mean, I'm ruining my life with these movies. I mean, all I do is see them. I'm losing my girlfriend. I lost my job. I mean,
all right.
Story, what?
All right, we have to get serious now.
Oh,
come on,
okay.
Get over here. Come on. Over here. Come on. Quick. Now, you see what it is? You've got to understand one thing. You don't know what pain is.
I'm learning.
Now, I want you to do one thing to me. Whenever you feel an attack like this coming on, wherever you are, say you're in the street, you're walking down the street, you feel an attack coming on of the movie, you throw yourself into a telephone booth and beat yourself up. I mean, tear yourself apart. And even if you beg for mercy, don't listen to yourself.
No.
Just grab yourself and tear yourself apart. And I'm going to give you some pills for the pain.
Oh.
It'll also relax you. Give me some pain pills. Yes, take 12 of those.
12.
Yes, that's it. The time I felt them to... That you got. Okay, now, take 12 of those every hour. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
12 of those, and that'll relieve you from the pain. It'll also relax you, okay? You're cured.
Oh.
There you go. That's it.
Huh.
And don't forget, 12 pills every hour. Uh-huh. Or is it, wait a minute, or is it one pill every 12 hours? Could be one pill every 12 days. You got, what's the instructions that came with those pills?
Make 17. You ought to hit the jackpot with one of them. Go ahead.
Hello? Is this Ginger Gray? It is? Well, this is your little Snookums. I'm about to do you a big favor. Will you marry me? Oh.
Hey, any luck?
I've got one phone number and one nickel left. Well, start using it. Clumsy ox, you. Where'd that go?
It went down here someplace.
Let's find it.
Let's go over that side.
Oh, no. Take this receiver off.
I got it.
All right. Now, wait a minute. Can you dial from there?
No, can you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Get your hand out of my face.
That ain't my hand, it's your hand.
All right, you asked for it. Ow!
All right, wait a minute. All right.
Can't stand it anymore.
It started with the book, didn't it?
Mo, where's your hat? How you doing?
I'm sorry I'm late, but something came up.
Like what?
Yes, what?
I was kidnapped by Darth Vader.
He's different. You never can tell what he's going to do or say. Howard, just for today, don't do or say anything.